The special prosecutor in the Russian election Trump campaign investigation is now using multiple grand juries, according to USA Today. Whoa, some would think, are they getting ready to indict somebody right now? This is getting serious real fast, some would say.
Chris, though, found out, a federal grand jury is a lot more than a group that just charges people with crimes. The grand jury can also be a grand tool for investigators.
Could you imagine being plucked from your day job to sit on a secret grand jury and be able to personally ask, say, the president of the United States, if he worked with Russia during the campaign? That could happen. May have already happened, and we won't know because it's secret. And it's designed that way for a reason.
Did you use grand jury a lot?
All the time.
Steve Schlischer is a former federal prosecutor who led the Wetterling case against Danny Heinrich.
So just to be totally accurate and simply put, does the fact that Robert Mueller is starting to use a grand jury mean he's about to criminally charge somebody?
It does not. What it means is that he is gathering evidence from a variety of sources. Maybe some of those sources are willing, maybe some of those sources are not willing.
So here's a grand jury. You got this room. It includes 16 to 23 jurors. You got to be 18 with no criminal convictions. There's a prosecutor, a court reporter, and a witness. And that's it. No judge, no defense attorney, no attorney with the witness, no reporters. That's it. On the state level, grand juries are typically used to decide if there's enough evidence to charge someone, say for first-degree murder. But on the federal level, it's also used as a sharp and potent investigative tool.
In practice, why would you go and seek a grand jury instead of going down to that office's door and knocking on it and saying, CEO, I need to talk to you?
Because as soon as the CEO decides that he doesn't want to talk to me, he might hit the shredder, right? I mean, when I hit somebody with a grand jury subpoena as a federal prosecutor, it preserved all of the documents. It put people on notice that there was some sort of an investigation going on.
And then it becomes criminal if you start messing with
it. That's correct.
So you get people under oath with real punishment for lying. But there's also this complete secrecy.
The witness testimony, the documents that are produced, all of those are protected by grand jury secrecy. They cannot be shared with anyone outside of the grand jury room except in the performance of official law enforcement duties.
And if the Mueller investigation never produces criminal charges, the public may never know what was said in these grand jury sessions.
If no charges ever issue, then the grand jury materials would remain secret forever. The witness statements would never come to light.
So one thing I found incredibly interesting about the difference between a grand jury juror and a trial juror is that in a trial, you sit there and you watch all the evidence and you watch the prosecutor, defense attorneys, and they do their thing, and you sit there like a judge as a witness, and you're passive, right, until deliberations. In the grand jury process, you can ask questions to the witness.
Oh, interesting.
As a juror. So literally, if the president came in and you asked, you could ask him questions personally. And I just thought that was really interesting. It's almost like you become the investigator.
Huh.
Yeah. And it's just a check and balance,
like,
you know,
a PhD multiple people. Jury.
Yeah.
Super, super duper special jury.
Yeah, you wonder, and just finding those people to sit on that jury must be a super interesting process, too.
It's the same thing.
Yeah it's the
Welcome,
same process.
Just like a regular trial thing. So, you know, you're a construction worker.
Yep.
You vote.
Gotta go.
Come on in, ask some questions. Yeah.
And right, you're on it for a long time.
I don't know how long until they need
well,
you.
Well, I just figured if you got called for this case, you better call your boss.
Got a good excuse, though.
It's going down.
We'll be right back.